Thank you. Thank you. We thanks God for His blessing and mercy and kindness, and is leading us until this Sabbath morning, so we can gather here to worship Him and to learn the Word of God. Before we start our Sabbath school program, let's prepare our heart and mind to invite the Holy Spirit by the silent prayer. Before we start our Sabbath school program, I would like to read our participant this Sabbath school program. As a pianist by Mahardika Pakpahan, as a chorister by Devin Hasibuan, and our opening song will take in from SD Hymnal number 466, and our memory verse and opening prayer will deliver by Elseba. And we will have a special song will deliver by Regita, Ruby, and Tasia. And a mission story will deliver by Serlius Arianto. And our closing song will take in from SD Hymnal number 326. And a closing prayer will deliver by Kevin Brandon. Let's worship God in spirit and in truth.
As the opening song, we sing SD Hymnal number 466, Wonderful Peace. Let us stand.
Far away of my spirit tonight rose a melody sweeter than song. In celestial like strains it unceasingly falls o'er my soul like an infinite calm. Peace, peace, wonderful peace coming down from the Father above. Sweep over my spirit forever, I pray, in fathomless billows of love. What a treasure I have in this wonderful peace, buried deep in my innermost soul, so secure that no power can ransom will sing in that heavenly eternity roll. Peace coming down from the Father above. Sweep over my spirit forever, I pray, in fathomless billows of love. I believe when I rise to city of peace, where the author of peace I shall see, that one strain of the song which the ransomed will sing in that heavenly kingdom will be. Peace, wonderful peace Father above. Sweep over my spirit forever, I pray. In fathomless billows of love, weary soul without gladness or comfort or rest, passing down the rough pathway of time, make the Savior your friend ere these shadows grow dark. Oh, accept of this peace so sublime. Peace, peace, wonderful peace, coming down from the Father. Fathomless billows of love.
Our memory verse today is taken from 1 Thessalonians 5, verse 21. Test everything, hold on to the good. Let's pray. Our Father in heaven, we humbly come before you to praise you for the gift of life, for the opportunity to spend this Sabbath day with you. May you send your Holy Spirit so all the things we learn from you, we can be able to apply in our daily life. May this worship be acceptable in your sight. Thank you, Lord. We all pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Now we will hear some beautiful special song from Regita, Ruby, and Tasia.
To hear thunder, always find He's never too far from wherever you are. Wherever you go, He already knows what lies ahead and what's behind. You'll always find that He's never too far from wherever.
Thank you for the special song from Regita, Ruby, and Tasia. And now let's prepare our heart and mind. We'll hear the mission story from Serlius Arianto.
Okay, happy Sabbath, everyone. Our mission story in the Sabbath day, the title is about Here Am I. It is by Andrew M.C. Chesney. It came from three different places. The first one is New York City, and the second one is from Panama, city of Panama, and the third one is from Australia. So, to be clear, we are going to watching a video that will show it by multimedia.
Including a life-size replica of the Rosetta Stone, a reproduction of King Tut's tomb, and genuine bricks from Babylon, with King Nebuchadnezzar's name stamped on them. While entertaining and educational, this unique center of influence has a deeper purpose of introducing individuals to the validity of the scriptures and to meaningful spiritual questions. Dr. Edward Urbina, in Central California, United States, heads up another type of mobile center of influence. The volunteers in this program offer free dental and vision care, following Christ's example of performing acts of service. Mobile clinics are set up at local churches using equipment that is transported in a large trailer. This ministry has a dual reach. Not only are they touching the lives of the people they serve, but also of those they serve with. 1/3 of the volunteers are professionals who are not Adventists. Some become intrigued about why the center offers its free services, and they want to learn more about the church's beliefs. Ellen White stated the urgency of reaching the vast population in big cities. She wrote, "Let not the fields lying in the shadow of our doors, such as the great cities in our land, be lightly passed over and neglected. The present time is the most favorable opportunity that we shall have to work in these fields. Are you inspired to use a vehicle to take a ministry to those in need within your city? Visit the Mission to the Cities website for more stories on mobile centers of influence."
Okay, by the video that we just watched before, it is explained our title in the Sabbath day about Here Am I, Send Me Lord. So the message that we got from the mission story, each one of us, God has given us a creative way to reach every friend of ours. So each of you in this moment, God has given us a mind to think, to help one each other. And the last point is, let each one reach one.
Thank you for the mission story that invite us to serve God, to serve our God in our daily life. We'll close our Sabbath school program by singing a song, and Corista will lead our song.
As the closing song, we sing SDA hymnal number 326, "Open My Eyes that I may See." Let us stand.
Thank you.
open my eyes that I may see glimpses of truth thou hast for me. Place in my hands the wonderful key that shall unclasp and set me free. Silently now I wait for thee. Ready, my God, thy will to see. Open my eyes, illumine me. Spirit divine, open my ears that I may hear voices of truth thou sendest clear. And while the wave notes fill in my ear, every false will disappear. Silently now I wait for thee. Ready, my God, thy will to see. Open my heart, illumine me. Spirit divine, open my mouth and let me bear gladly the warm truth everywhere. Open my heart and let me prepare love with thy children thus to share. Silently now I wait for thee. Ready, my God, thy will to see. Open my heart, illumine me. Spirit divine.
Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for the blessing that we received this morning. We just finished our worship, Sabbath school program. We have learned about a Sabbath school lesson, and we hear about the mission report, and we just collect our self-aware blessing that you give to us, God. May all the lesson that we heard, it could lead us in our act, in our word, so it could be just to glorify your name. God, we will continue our worship to divine worship. God, lead us, each one of us with your Holy Spirit, so we can just glorify your name. We just finish our worship program, our Sabbath school program. Lead us in the next worship. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Okay, this is the end of our Sabbath school program. And after this, we will hear some announcement. And let's prepare our heart and mind to our next divine worship. God bless us.
Dari depan ini kami mengucapkan selamat hari Sabat kepada saudara-saudara sekalian yang sudah hadir di Jemaat Unai, dan selamat datang juga dan selamat berbakti kami ucapkan kepada para tamu kami yang sudah hadir, khususnya kepada para orang tua, para wali, para sponsor, dari para wisudawan dan wisudawati yang akan dan selamat berbakti di Jemaat Unai. Kami juga mengucapkan selamat hari Sabat kepada para hamba-hamba Tuhan, para senior kami yang mungkin tidak sempat datang ke gereja ini dan menyaksikan melalui Zoom dan juga mengikuti melalui live streaming dari YouTube. Kami mengucapkan selamat hari Sabat. Kita akan memasuki akan jam pengumuman. Mohon perhatian daripada saudara-saudara untuk memperhatikan akan pengumuman yang kami bacakan pada hari Sabat ini. Kami memohon dengan sangat dan dengan kerendahan hati kepada saudara-saudara untuk menjaga kesucian dalam acara perbaktian ini, untuk tidak mengaktifkan handphone atau gadget atau sejenisnya, atau saudara bisa memindahkannya kepada nada getar. Demikian pula saudara-saudara, kita mengharapkan saudara-saudara untuk tetap menjaga akan protokol kesehatan. Saudara boleh menjaga jarak dan tetap menggunakan masker selama acara ibadah ini berlangsung. Pengkhotbah kita pada hari Sabat ini adalah Pendeta RW Sagala. Dan yang ketiga, pengumuman pada hari Sabat ini, kelas Adventurer Club akan diadakan pukul 14.30 dengan menggunakan seragam tipe A, menggunakan kacu dan bertempat di depan Old Building. Yang keempat, acara Pemuda Advent Sabat ini akan diadakan pukul 16.00 sampai selesai di Unai Alumni Chapel yang akan dibawakan oleh staf PA Unai. Ibadah Rabu malam tanggal 7 Desember akan diadakan pukul 18.30 dengan pembicara Bapak H. Saragi. Yang keenam, kebaktian Sabat depan tanggal 10 Desember akan diadakan di Unai Alumni Chapel dengan pengkhotbah Bapak Yunus Elon. Acara doa subuh BWA tanggal 4 Desember 2022 akan diadakan melalui online dan diadakan pukul 5 pagi. Dan yang terakhir, bangku D dan E yang ada di gedung ini akan lebih dikhususkan untuk para mahasiswa karena dengan seating arrangement yang sudah mereka miliki. Dan bagi para tamu, para bapak dan staf dosen, ibu, boleh menggunakan bangku A dan juga bangku H. Demikian pengumuman untuk dapat diperhatikan. Mari kita tunduk kepala dan kita berdoa. Terpujilah Engkau ya Tuhan Allah Bapa di surga. Kiranya Tuhan akan memberkati kami dan menyertai kami dalam perbaktian kami. Khususnya ya Tuhan, hamba Tuhan, Pendeta RW Sagala akan membawakan firman Tuhan. Tuhan akan memberkati beliau. Tuhan akan berbicara melalui beliau. Sehingga firman Tuhan berkuasa. Dan kami yang datang pada hari Sabat ini akan pulang dengan sukacita. Sertai kami yang akan mengikuti sepanjang ibadah ini. Biarlah Roh Kudus Tuhan menyertai hati dan pikiran kami. Dan biarlah ruangan ini ya Tuhan, solem adanya. Terpujilah nama-Mu Tuhan, ampuni kami Tuhan dari segala dosa. Hapuskanlah dosa kami Tuhan. Di dalam nama Tuhan Yesus, kami telah berdoa. Amin. Mari kita berbakti dalam roh dan kebenaran.
Jesus. SD hymnal number 495, Near to the Heart of God. Please stand up.
There is a place of quiet rest near to the heart of God, a place where sin cannot molest, near to the heart of God. Oh, Jesus blessed,
everyone. Our responsive reading this morning is taken from Hebrews 10 verses 22 to 25. I'll be reading the first verse, then we shall read alternately, and then the last verse we shall read it in unison. Let us draw near to God with a sincere heart and with the full assurance that faith brings, having our hearts sprinkled to cleanse us from a guilty conscience, and having our bodies washed with pure water. And let us consider how we may spur one another on toward love and good deeds together. Not giving up together, as some in the habit of doing, but encouraging one another, and all the more you see the day approaching.
SD hymnal number 474, Take the Name of Jesus With You.
Take the name of Jesus with you, child of sorrow and of woe. It will joy and comfort give you, take it then where'er you go. Precious name, oh how sweet, hope of earth and joy of heaven. Precious name, oh how sweet, hope of earth and joy of heaven. Take the name of Jesus ever as a shield from every snare. If temptations round you gather, breathe that holy name in prayer. Precious name, oh how sweet, hope of earth and joy of heaven. Precious name, oh how sweet, hope of earth and joy of heaven. Oh, the precious name of Jesus, how
way thrills our soul with joy. When His loving arms receive us, and His songs our tongues employ. Precious name, oh how sweet, hope of earth and joy of heaven. Precious name, oh how sweet, hope of earth and joy of heaven. At the name of Jesus bowing, falling prostrate at His feet, King of kings in heaven will crown Him when our journey is complete. Precious name, oh how sweet, hope of earth and joy of heaven. Precious name, oh how sweet, hope of earth and joy of heaven.
Let's all kneel down to seek the Lord in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, You are our all-powerful and yet merciful God. We totally depend upon You, Lord, for everything in our lives. Father, we have gathered here ready to listen to Your words that will be given to us by Pastor Sagala and Pastor Pani. Bless them, Lord, so that their lips may be ordained, touched by the Holy Spirit. Especially us that have come to listen to this Your word, Father. Please cleanse our hearts, our minds. Empty us from anything worldly, Father, so we may be filled with Your Holy Spirit and be ready for Your words. Father, forgive us all our sins. In Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Yeah.
Shalom, selamat pagi kita semua. Selamat Sabat. Pada hari Sabat ini kami dari Tailgiven Vocal Group akan bawakan satu lagu pujian untuk memuliakan nama Tuhan, di mana lagu ini temponya sedikit cepat. Jadi kami ingin menjelaskan kepada teman-teman bahwa lagu ini menceritakan bagaimana Tuhan begitu baik, begitu luar biasa melepaskan bangsa Israel keluar dari tanah Mesir. Dan itu juga sama bagaimana Tuhan melepaskan kita dari jerat dosa. Dan ini menceritakan bagaimana luar biasanya Tuhan yang penuh kasih telah memberikan kepada kita sebuah kebebasan. Dan kiranya lagu ini menjadi berkat bagi kita semua, dan kiranya Tuhan memberkati kita.
Held in Egypt's bondage, I have long a wandered been.
Just the same, just the strangers
of long ago. Just as much a miracle that led me out of sin.
Oh, I believe
the hands of Pharaoh. The hands of Pharaoh.
Delivered
out.
Jehovah's
wondrous mind.
He walks with me, beside his side, hallelujah.
Cloud by day and fire by night.
Deliver
I believe in the hands of Pharaoh.
From the hands of
Israel rejoiced when they walked out upon the shore.
Just the same as long ago.
So my feeble voice I raise His goodness to adore.
Oh, I believe in
the hands of Pharaoh.
Delivered
out by Jehovah's wondrous might.
He walks with me, hallelujah.
Cloud
by day and bright fire by night.
Deliver
us
from the hands of Pharaoh.
Hallelujah,
cloud
by day and bright fire by night.
Deliver us
from the hands of Pharaoh.
I would like to ask the deacon and deaconesses to please come forward. Tithe and offerings reading for this Sabbath is taken from Psalm 145, verse 15. It says, "The eyes of all who look to you, and you give them their food and the proper time, at the proper time." We worship God with our resources because He often makes provisions for our needs even before they arise. In a dream, the Lord informed Pharaoh about the 7 years of severe famine that would strike Egypt. However, before the beginning of the crisis, He provided 7 years of abundance. Under the inspired leadership of Joseph, they could save the surplus and adequately prepare for the crisis. God provided the need. Joseph told his brothers about the God who acted in anticipation. In Genesis 45 verse 7, it says, "But God sent me ahead of you to preserve for you a remnant of earth and to save your lives by the great deliverance." Our needs and emergencies of today never take God by surprise or put him off balance. During the COVID-19 pandemic, a family had witnessed how God acted in anticipation of their needs. Because they were staying in a foreign country, the wife had to renew her employment authorization. The process took much longer than expected. After a few months of waiting, her current work authorization expired, and she was terminated from her job. The family budget was not balanced anymore. At first, they thought that the authorization would come in a few days. It was not so. Interestingly, exactly 7 months before she lost her job, the week that many companies were closing down and dismissing employees, causing a record height of unemployment, she miraculously held onto her job. This allowed the family to consolidate their emergency fund, not knowing the challenge they would soon face. Regularly, they would check the status of her application. The waiting time grew from 3 months to 4 months to 5 months, and finally up to 9 months. It was a testing time. During this extended time, their consolidated emergency fund kept them afloat. More accurately, it was the work of God who made provision even before their needs arose. This week, as we worship with our tithe and regular offerings, called Promise, let us show our gratitude to the Provider, who already has solution for our unseen crisis. Our prayer, Lord, we worship because you do not only know our future, you have already prepared a way for us. You are our special Provider. The deacon and the deaconess will serve you as we worship the Lord with our tithe and offering. Thank you.
SDA hymnal number 16, All People That on Earth Do Dwell. Let us stand.
All people that on earth do dwell, sing to the Lord with cheerful voice. Him serve with mirth, his praise forth tell. Come ye before him and rejoice.
We pray. Father in heaven, we want to thank you for the opportunity to worship you, Lord, through our offering and tithe. Bless this offering and tithe to hasten your work and to fasten your second coming. Bless all of us, Father, that we may have our faith and honest in returning the offering and the tithe. We worship you, Lord. We ask for the forgiveness of our sin. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. The servant of God, Pastor Sagala, in delivering his message, has given a text, a main text for his sermon, found in Ephesians 4, verses 1 to 3. Ephesians chapter 4, verses 1 to 3. As a prisoner for the Lord, then I urge you to live a life worthy of the calling you have received. Be completely humble and gentle. Be patient, bearing with one another in love. Make every effort to keep the unity of the Spirit through the bond of peace. God bless us. May we worship in spirit and righteousness.
Into my heart. Into my heart. Into my
Selamat Sabat, saudara-saudara yang kekasih di dalam nama Yesus Kristus.
Happy Sabbath to everyone in the name of Jesus Christ.
Senang sekali, tidak terasa kita sudah akan segera mengakhiri semester ini dan ini adalah merupakan Sabat terakhir bagi kita berbakti bersama-sama.
We are so glad because we are about to finish our academic year for the first semester and then maybe this is the last Sabat for us in this semester.
Khususnya bagi saya ini adalah merupakan satu sabat yang istimewa.
For me especially, this is very special sabat.
Mengapa?
Why?
Karena dua orang yang duduk di sebelah kanan dan di sebelah kiri saya adalah sahabat saya.
Because two my friends beside me is my friends.
Bukan berarti Pak Hutapea tidak sahabat saya.
Not because not Mr. Hutapea is not.
Kita semua bersahabat.
Because we are friends.
But these two men is very special for me.
But this Tapi orang yang dua ini sangat istimewa bagi saya.
Mr. Joshua Tobing is my classmate.
Bapak Joshua Tobing adalah teman sekelas saya.
Dr. Exxon Pane is my student.
Dan Dr. Pane adalah murid saya.
My ex-church pastor.
Bekas pendeta gereja saya.
And now my college, my teman saya, my friend.
Sekarang adalah sahabat saya dalam pelayanan.
Sama-sama menjadi dosen.
Same as a lecturer here.
Jadi kalau saya, kalau pendeta Exxon maksud saya, mengajar salah di kelasnya, yang salah bukan dia, tapi saya.
If Pastor Exxon maybe teach something wrong in the classroom, he's not the wrong one, but me.
Tapi kalau dia mengajarnya bagus, yang baik itu dia, bukan saya.
Thank you.
Terima kasih, karena Anda tersenyum. Baiklah, pada hari Sabat ini, kita akan sama-sama belajar dari firman Tuhan.
Now we are going to talk about the glory of God.
Judul dari pelajaran kita pada acara khotbah ini adalah Tuhan memberikan kesatuan yang terbaik.
The title of my sermon this beautiful Sabbat is God gives the best unity.
Kalau Anda lupa terhadap khotbah saya semua,
if you forget maybe all my sermons in the past,
bahkan Anda juga lupa apa judul khotbahnya,
and maybe you forget about the title of the sermon,
itu boleh-boleh saja.
Never mind.
Tapi jangan pernah lupa satu kata ini.
But don't forget this word.
Unity.
Persatuan.
Or the importance of unity.
Pentingnya persatuan.
Saudara, tujuan khotbah kita pada sahabat ini adalah
the purpose of the sermon, this beautiful sahabat is
untuk menyoroti pentingnya persatuan dan kesatuan jemaat.
Highlighting the importance of the church unity and cohesion.
Serta mengetahui pengaruh buruk dari perceraian.
And it backs effects about divisions.
Sehingga setiap anggota jemaat berusaha agar mengusahakan terjadinya kesatuan.
So that every church members create the unity.
Masing-masing kita punya 5 jari.
I think we have all 5
fingers.
Boleh
diangkat jarinya?
Can you raise your hand?
Your boleh fingers, diangkat?
I mean.
Ada yang 7?
Do you have 7 fingers?
Mudah-mudahan semuanya 5.
I think 5.
Yang kanan. Ya. Kalau dengan yang kiri 10.
Oke. Okay.
Kita punya 5 jari. Kelima jari kita ini punya nama, punya bentuk, dan punya kegunaan yang berbeda-beda.
They have names, they have shapes, and then different uses.
Ada yang lebih tinggi.
They are higher
dari jari yang lainnya
than other fingers.
Sebaliknya ada pula yang diciptakan lebih pendek.
And vice versa.
Kelima jari tersebut diciptakan unik dan berbeda satu dengan yang lainnya.
Five fingers are created unique and different from one another.
Tetapi perbedaan tersebut tidak membuat mereka bergerak sendiri-sendiri.
But the differences do not make them move independently.
Kalau satu bergerak, yang lain juga akan ikut bergerak.
If one move, another one will be move.
Mereka melakukan pekerjaan dengan adanya kesatuan.
They work together.
Dengan setiap kelebihan dan kekurangan masing-masing,
with the weakness and the strength,
mereka bersatu untuk mencapai tujuan mereka.
They are united to achieve their goal.
Saudaraku, persatuan dan kesatuan sangat diperlukan untuk kecurahan Roh Kudus dan kebangunan rohani.
My brothers and sisters, unity and oneness are indispensable for the outpouring of the Holy Spirit.
Apalagi sementara kita menantikan kedatangan Yesus yang kedua kali.
Especially for those who are waiting for the second coming of Jesus Christ.
Dan kebangunan rohani itu akan terjadi ketika gereja dipersatukan.
And revival will occur when the church is united.
Berfokus kepada pesan Tuhan dan bersemangat dalam menjalankan misi yang Tuhan berikan.
Focus on the message of God and passionate about the carrying of his missions.
Itulah sebabnya kita harus menjauhkan kepentingan-kepentingan diri.
That's why we need to throw away all our self-interest.
Dan kemudian bersatu untuk mencapai tujuan kita.
And then we can unite to achieve a goal.
Saya sengaja membawa judul khotbah ini karena kita akan segera liburan.
Okay, I took this title because we are going to have a vacation.
Agar kita mengingat bahwa setelah nanti kita pulang kemari, kita akan tetap bersatu.
So that we remember when we come back here, we still have unison.
Persatuan adalah merupakan unsur penting dari suatu kebangunan.
Unity is essential element for revival.
Ingat pada hari Pentakosta?
Do you remember on the Pentecost day?
Pada hari Pentakosta, Roh Kudus dicurahkan atas gereja yang telah bersatu.
The Holy Spirit was outpouring for the church that has been united.
Mereka bersatu untuk menjalankan misi yang Kristus berikan kepada
mereka. They were united to carry the gospel.
Roh Kudus tidak dicurahkan kepada murid-murid itu selagi mereka merasa diri mereka lebih penting dari yang lain.
The Holy Spirit will not give to them if they feel that they are more important than others.
Saudaraku, jika pengikut Kristus yang mula-mula itu sibuk bersaing untuk kekuasaan,
my brothers, if the early followers of Christ were busy competing for power,
maka pekerjaan Tuhan dari sejak awal akan terhalang.
Then God's work would be hindered from the beginning.
Sebaliknya,
instead,
ditegur oleh Roh Kudus untuk mati bagi diri sendiri,
rebuked by the Holy Spirit to die to the self,
mereka dipersatukan dalam tujuan dan misi.
They are united in purpose and missions.
Saudara, di mana tidak ada persatuan, tidak akan pernah ada kebangunan.
My brother, where there is no unity, there is no revival.
Di mana kecemburuan, iri hati saling menyikut untuk keunggulan dan berkuasa,
where there is no envy, nudge each other for superiority and for dominion,
maka kuasa Roh Kudus pun tidak akan diberikan.
Then the power of the Holy Spirit will not be given.
Itulah sebabnya pada hari Sabat ini,
that's why in the Sabbath day,
kita akan sama-sama belajar bagaimana membuang segala hambatan yang memisahkan kita.
That's why we are going to learn to get rid of all the barriers that separate us.
Agar kita dapat mengalami dan mendapatkan kesatuan yang Kristus inginkan.
So that we have the experience that Jesus Christ want us to do.
Khususnya kepada kita umat-umat Tuhan yang ada pada akhir zaman ini.
Especially for those of us who are living in the last days.
Saudara, Injil Yohanes pasal yang ke-17.
My brothers, the gospel in the John 17.
Mencatat bagaimana Yesus berdoa untuk pada murid.
Recording how Jesus pray to his disciple.
Agar mereka memiliki satu hubungan yang dekat dengan satu sama lain.
So that they would have a close relationship with one another.
Sama seperti bagaimana dekatnya hubungan Kristus dengan Bapanya.
Just like his relationship with his Father in heaven.
Jika saudara membawa Alkitab, mari.
If you bring your Bible,
buka Alkitab.
Please open your Bible.
Buka Yohanes pasal 17.
Just open your Bible, John 17, verse 1 to 20.
Sekiranya Anda tidak sempat membaca di sini, nanti baca di kamarmu masing-masing.
You can read in your respective room.
Dan Yohanes 17 ini adalah mencatat tentang doa Tuhan Yesus.
John 17 is recording about the prayer of Jesus Christ.
Sebenarnya,
actually,
yang dimaksud dengan doa Tuhan Yesus itu bukan doa Bapa kami.
The prayer of the Lord is not the Lord's prayer.
Karena itu adalah untuk kita.
Because that is for us.
Yesus katakan jika engkau berdoa,
Jesus tell us if you pray,
berdoalah seperti ini.
Pray like this.
Baru dia sebutkan doa Bapa kami itu.
And then he said the Lord's prayer.
Tapi dalam Yohanes 17,
but if you go to the John 17,
ini adalah betul-betul doa Kristus.
This is indeed the prayer of Jesus.
Dalam Yohanes 17 ini ada tiga bahagian doa Kristus ini.
In John 17 there are three parts of the Lord's prayer.
Dan Saya pikir perlu juga kita meniru cara Yesus berdoa ini.
I think we need to copy how Jesus pray.
Pertama, dia berdoa untuk dirinya sendiri.
First, he pray for himself.
Itu bisa Anda lihat dalam Yohanes 17 ayat 1 sampai 8.
You can see in John 17 verse 1 to 8.
Kemudian bagian yang kedua dia berdoa untuk muridnya.
And the second part is about he pray for his disciples.
Yohanes 17 ayat 9 sampai 19.
From verses 9 to 19.
Kemudian yang ketiga dia berdoa untuk umat-umatnya, yaitu saudara dan saya sekarang ini.
And then finally he pray for his people and to brothers and me.
Yohanes 17 ayat 20 sampai 26.
It's recording in John 17 verse 20 to 26, sorry.
Dapatkah Anda bayangkan?
Can you imagine?
Ribuan tahun yang lalu,
thousand years ago,
Yesus sudah berdoa untuk
Jesus
Anda dan
pray
saya.
For you and me.
Begitu pentingnya diri kita bagi Yesus Kristus.
How important is us for Jesus Christ?
Dia berdoa untuk saudara dan saya.
He pray for you and me.
Apa yang Yesus minta kepada Allah Bapa saat dia mendoakan kita?
What did Jesus ask to the Father when he prayed for us?
Coba Anda baca dalam Yohanes 17 ayat 22.
Please read John 17 verse 22.
Dalam ayat ini disebutkan supaya mereka menjadi satu sama seperti kita adalah satu.
In this verse it states that they may be one just as we are one.
Yesus tidak mendoakan kita supaya kaya.
Jesus never prayed for us so that we have rich.
Yang Yesus doakan adalah supaya kita sebagai umatnya yang hidup di akhir zaman bersatu.
But he pray for our unity in this last day.
Saudara, kesatuan atau persatuan dari para murid Kristus adalah merupakan kunci utama untuk menyiapkan hati mereka menerima kepenuhan Roh Kudus.
Unity and oneness of Christ's discipleship is the main key to receive the outpouring of the Holy Spirit.
Dan doa Kristus bagi jemaatnya pada saat itu terpenuhi.
And the Christ prayer at the time was fulfilled.
Demikian juga kalau kita berdoa untuk kesatuan saat ini, pasti akan dijawab oleh Yesus dengan ya.
Therefore, as we pray for the unity, God will answer our prayer.
Apa buktinya?
What is the proof?
Mereka menyerahkan perbedaan mereka dan perselisihan mereka pun akhirnya dibuang.
They gave up all their differences and their discord was banished.
Saudaraku Ellen White menulis tentang kesatuan demikian.
Ellen White wrote about the unity like this.
Setelah para murid tiba kepada kesatuan yang sempurna,
after disciples arrive at the perfect unity,
ketika mereka tidak lagi berjuang untuk tempat yang tertinggi,
when they are no longer striving for the highest place,
maka roh dicurahkan.
Then the spirit was poured out.
Mereka sehati,
they are one heart,
segala perbedaan telah disingkirkan.
All the differences have been removed.
Hamba Tuhan Nyonya White jelas sekali mengatakan.
Ellen G. White clearly says.
Adalah setelah murid-murid itu bersatu.
When the disciples of Jesus Christ were united.
Maka Roh Kudus pun dicurahkan kepada mereka.
And then they are pouring the Holy Spirit given to them.
Saudara, mari kita perhatikan apa saja sih yang biasanya merupakan unsur-unsur persatuan itu.
Let us put our consider what is the elements of the unity.
Kisah 1 ayat 8 menuliskan.
Acts 1 verse 8 says like this.
Tetapi kamu akan menerima kuasa.
But you shall receive power.
Kalau Roh Kudus turun ke atas kamu.
If the Holy Spirit come upon you.
Dan kamu akan menjadi saksiku.
And you will be my witness.
Di Jerusalem.
Jerusalem,
di seluruh Judea,
Judea,
sampai Samaria,
in Samaria,
dan sampai ke ujung bumi,
and unto the uttermost part of the world.
Saudara, khususnya bagi kita anggota gereja Mas Advent hari ketujuh,
especially for you as a members of Adventist Church,
harus menyadari ini.
We need to realize.
Kita harus menyadari pentingnya persatuan.
We need to realize the important thing of the importance of the unity.
Seberapa hebat pun Anda berkhotbah.
How great our how to speak or to get the sermon.
Seberapa pintar pun kita mengajar,
even though we are good in teaching,
kalau kita tidak punya kesatuan,
but you don't have unity,
kita tidak akan dipenuhi oleh Roh Kudus.
The Holy Spirit will not fill us.
Perintah Kristus untuk membawa Injil ke seluruh dunia telah menjadi ambisi pribadi para murid itu.
Christ's command to take the gospel throughout the world become the ambition of the disciples of Jesus Christ.
Jemaat tidak akan dapat menjangkau masyarakat dengan Injil jika tidak ada kesatuan di dalam gereja.
The congregation, all the church members will not be able to reach people to the gospel if there is no unity.
Saudara, misi adalah faktor pemersatu yang besar.
My brothers, mission is the great unifying factor.
Orang yang percaya yang mula-mula itu bersatu demi untuk mencapai misi mereka.
Those early believers banded together to accomplish their mission.
Kehidupan, kematian, kebangkitan, pelayanan, keimamatan, kedatangan kembali Tuhan, kesatuanlah yang mengikat itu.
The life, the death, the resurrection, and the priesthood of ministry, the return of the Lord bound them.
Sehingga dengan demikian,
then,
orang-orang yang baru bertobat tetap setia dalam pengajaran para rasul itu.
The new believers remain faithful to the teaching of the
pengajaran
apostles.
Yesus menjadi dasar persatuan mereka.
The teaching of Jesus become the basis of their unity.
Sekarang ini di hari-hari terakhir sejarah dunia,
now in the last days of the world history,
Allah juga telah memberikan kepada umatnya suatu desakan.
God has also given his people the exhortation,
yaitu pekabaran masa kini yang harus kita sampaikan.
A present message that we are going to tell.
Dan pekabaran masa inilah yang menyatukan orang-orang Advent sekarang ini.
The present message is the one who unites the Adventists in this day.
Sebagai suatu keluarga Allah.
As a family of God.
Adakah proklamasi pekabaran nubuatan tiga malaikat yang memberikan alasan kepada orang untuk keberadaan kita?
The three angel message is the key why we exist as Adventists.
Para murid berfokus pada penyelesaian tugas yang telah diberikan Yesus kepada mereka.
The disciple of Jesus focus on the mission that God has given to them.
Mereka berkomitmen untuk memberikan pesan tentang kasih Kristus kepada dunia.
They were committed to give the message of Christ to the world.
Saudara, perpecahan mengganggu dan menghambat misi gereja.
My brother, division disturb and hinder the mission of the church.
Sekali lagi, betapa hebatnya pun kita berkhotbah dan mengajar, kalau tidak ada persatuan, maka pekabaran kita akan sia-sia.
Once again, even though we are good in preaching, but if we don't have any unity, it will be nothing.
Konflik menciptakan kekacauan.
Conflict create chaos.
Dan Kristus akan menjauh dari kita jika kita memelihara kekacauan.
And Christ will return away from us if we keep or maintain the chaos.
Pertanyaan untuk kita pikirkan.
The question for us.
Apakah sumbangan yang dapat atau yang dapat kita berikan kepada persatuan dan kesatuan jemaat kita?
What contribution that we can do for the unity in our church?
Sementara kita memikirkan di dalam hati kita masing-masing, apakah yang dapat kita berikan agar ada persatuan di jemaat kita?
While we are thinking about what is the contribution that we can do for the unity of the church,
kembali kita akan mendengarkan nyanyian spesial oleh Till Given Vocal Group.
We're going to hear a special number by Till Given Vocal Group.
Sementara mendengarkan lagu spesial ini,
while we are waiting for a special song,
tanyakan kepada diri Anda.
Ask yourself.
Apa yang saya berikan di dalam memberikan kesatuan di jemaat?
What contribution should I give for the unity of the church?
Oh. that this life with its great mysteries surely one day will come to an end. Oh, but faith will conquer the darkness and death and will lead me at last to my friend.
Oh, I believe that the Christ who was slain on the cross has the power to change lives today.
Praise God for the beautiful song.
Kita puji Tuhan dengan lagu yang luar biasa.
Terima kasih kita ucapkan kepada Till Given Vocal Group.
Thank you for the Till Given Vocal Group.
Saya cemburu kepada mereka.
I'm jealous.
Khususnya yang suara empat.
Especially the bass.
Karena saya gak bisa suara empat.
So saya akan do it.
Beberapa kali terus saya latihan-latihan gak bisa.
Many times I try it but I cannot.
Tapi kepada mereka Tuhan berikan talenta-talenta.
But God give them talent.
Puji Tuhan sekali lagi untuk lagu tersebut.
Praise the Lord for the wonderful song.
Baik, saudaraku yang kekasih di dalam nama Yesus Kristus.
My brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ.
Setelah kita membicarakan sedikit tentang kesatuan, maka pada saat ini kita akan lihat apa saja sih yang merupakan struktur persatuan itu.
Now we are going to talk about the structure of the unity.
Kisah para Rasul 20 ayat 17 dan 28.
You can open your Bible, Acts 20 verse 17 and 28.
Karena itu ia menyuruh seorang dari Miletus ke Efesus dengan pesan supaya para penetua jemaat datang ke Miletus.
From Miletus he sent Ephesus and called for the elders of the church.
Karena itu jagalah dirimu dan jagalah seluruh kawanan.
Therefore take heed and to yourself and to all the flock.
Karena kamulah yang ditetapkan Roh Kudus menjadi penilik untuk menggembalakan jemaat Allah.
Among which the Holy Spirit has been made you overseers.
Yang diperolehnya dengan darah anak-anaknya.
That you purchased by his own blood.
Saudara yang kekasih.
My brothers.
Di dalam perjanjian baru dinyatakan bahwa gereja mula-mula memiliki struktur organisasi yang pasti.
In the New Testament, it stated that the early church has definite organizational structure.
Yang pertama, tujuan organisasi itu adalah dibentuk sedemikian rupa, punya struktur, tujuannya adalah untuk membantu menjaga kemurnian doktrin gereja.
The first function of the structure is to help the maintain the purity of the church doctrine.
Ini jugalah tujuan persatuan kita agar masing-masing kita menjaga kemurnian doktrin gereja.
That is also our goal of the unity, to maintain the purity of the church doctrine.
Saya ada mengikuti beberapa WA group.
I have a WhatsApp number group.
Dan pada minggu ini,
and this week,
saya lihat ada di satu WA group
I saw in a group WhatsApp number.
Saya tidak sebutkan WA apa itu.
Well, I don't mention the name of the WhatsApp number group.
Tetapi saya tahu beberapa dosen di sini anggota itu juga, anggota grup itu.
But some of the lecturers here is the members of the group.
Dan salah satu yang mereka bahas minggu ini adalah tentang pengajaran-pengajaran di luar dari pengajaran Advent.
They talk about teaching outside of the Adventist doctrine.
Saudara, adanya ajaran-ajaran yang tidak sesuai dengan ajaran gereja Advent ini akan membawa kehancuran, bukan kesatuan.
The teaching that come to this Adventist church will take away our unity.
Itulah sebabnya masing-masing kita bertanggung jawab untuk menjaga kemurnian doktrin gereja kita.
That's why we have responsibility to maintain the purity of the doctrine.
Yang kedua,
the second one is
adalah memelihara gereja agar tetap fokus kepada misi.
Keeping the church focus on his mission.
Saudara, apa yang menjadi misi gereja kita?
What is the mission of our church?
Saya yakin benar bahwa semua Anda yang mengikuti kelas-kelas di PA,
I think that all of you follow the class in the youth program,
mengerti,
understand,
bahwa misi kita adalah menyampaikan pekabaran Injil ke seluruh dunia.
Our mission is to tell the good news to over the world.
Kita harus tertuju kepada misi itu.
Our focus in mission.
Di gereja kita,
in our church,
banyak sekali ada jabatan-jabatan.
There are many parts in our church.
Salah satu adalah diakon.
One of them is deacons.
Para diakon dipilih untuk membagi-bagikan makanan pada saat itu.
Deacons were selected and the time or those time to distribute food.
Paulus diarahkan ke Ananias, seorang perwakilan dari gereja.
Paul was directed to Ananias as a representative of the church.
Paulus bertemu pemimpin-pemimpin gereja di Jerusalem.
Paul met church leaders in Jerusalem.
Paulus bertemu tua-tua gereja di Efesus.
Paul met the church elders in Ephesus.
Anggota gereja menerima keputusan para pemimpin dalam pertemuan mereka di Jerusalem.
Church members accepted the decisions of the leaders at the meeting.
Semuanya itu adalah merupakan faktor yang mendukung kesatuan gereja
all
pada zaman itu.
The factors to support the unity.
Saudaraku, umat percaya dalam perjanjian baru bersatu pada nilai-nilai utama penciptaan dan penebusan.
My brothers, in the New Testament, believers are united on the central values of creation and redemption.
Mereka mengajarkan bahwa semua manusia diciptakan oleh Allah.
That is that all human beings created by God.
Dan bahwa penebusan telah disediakan bagi semua orang melalui salib Kristus.
And redemption has been provided for all people through the cross of Jesus Christ.
Salib menunjukkan bahwa setiap orang tanpa memandang status duniawinya adalah berharga di pemandangan Allah.
The cross shows that everyone, regardless our worldly status, we are the precious in sight of God.
Rasul Paulus menggambarkan,
Apostle Paulus says,
bahwa anggota-anggota gereja, tubuh Kristus itu,
the members of the church or the body of the church, Christ,
saling terkait dan saling tergantung satu sama lain.
The body is tightly knit, its members interrelated and interdependent one another.
Setiap bagian mempunyai fungsinya masing-masing.
Each part has a own function.
Jika satu bagian dari tubuh menderita, seluruh tubuh akan menderita.
If one part of the body suffers, the whole body suffers too.
Saudara, salah satu masalah utama dalam gereja adalah perpecahan di antara anggota gereja.
My brothers, the main problems in the church is division among the members.
Dalam 1 Korintus 12, Paulus menjelaskan,
in the 1 Corinthians, Paul says,
perbedaan tidak perlu mengarah pada perpecahan.
Even though we are different, but not lead to divisions.
Saudara, persatuan bukan berarti keseragaman.
My brother, unity does not mean uniformity.
Saya tidak mungkin sama dengan Pendeta Pane.
Me, myself, is not the same with Pastor Pane.
Kita masing-masing berbeda.
We are different.
Dia pintar menyanyi.
No, sir.
Saya sedang-sedang saja.
be the same.
Anda pintar mengajar, yang lain pintarnya melayani.
Some of people good in teaching and some of people good in ministry others.
Perbedaan sekali lagi tidak membuat persatuan itu menjadi kacau.
The difference is not make the unity become division.
Saudaraku, saya mencatat di sini ada beberapa negara yang memiliki suku terbanyak di dunia.
My brothers, I wrote here some countries with the most ethnic group in this world.
India.
India.
Tahukah Anda berapa etnis yang ada di sana?
Do you know how many ethnic group? 2000 ethnicities.
Tiga etnis teratas India adalah orang Hindu atau Urdu.
There are three tops ethnicity, Hindu or Urdu.
48%.
48%.
Bengali ada 8%.
Bengali 8%.
Telugu 7%.
Telugu 7%.
Indonesia.
How about Indonesia?
Menurut tahun
2000, the statistic 2010.
Ada 1340 suku atau etnis di Indonesia.
Indonesia has 1340 ethnic group.
Dan etnis Jawa adalah merupakan kelompok suku terbesar.
Javanese ethnicity is the largest ethnic group in Indonesia.
41%.
Wow, 41%.
Papua juga begitu, ada 1000 etnis.
Papua New Guinea 100 ethnic.
Meksiko ada 65 etnis, ada 292 bahasa.
290.
Negara Kesatuan Indonesia,
Republik Indonesia,
Bhinneka Tunggal Ika.
Bhinneka Tunggal Ika.
Anda lihat pakaiannya pun berbeda-beda.
You can see.
Bahasanya pun berbeda-beda.
It's different.
Tapi kita ini adalah satu.
But we are one.
Menurut catatan saya di sini,
according to my record here,
jumlah dan persentase penduduk suku bangsa, kelompok suku bangsa di Indonesia itu ada berbagai macam ragam.
The numbers of population of Indonesia, percentage of Indonesia,
yang paling banyak adalah etnis atau suku Jawa.
The largest one is the Javanese.
Kemudian Sunda.
And Sundanese.
Kemudian Batak.
And Bataknese.
Saya kaget juga ini kalau suku saya termasuk nomor tiga.
I was shocked that
saya pikir I'm tadi my, di luar my tribe 10 is number besar. Three. Oh. Yeah, I think it out from 10.
Oke, okay, saya pikir itu tidak luar dari 10.
Yeah. Nah, sama seperti organ-organ tubuh yang berbeda memiliki fungsi yang berbeda,
just as a different organ, as a body have a different function,
tetapi semuanya dipadukan ke seluruh tubuh untuk kebaikan tubuh.
But all are integrated throughout the body for the good of our body.
Demikian juga setiap anggota gereja diberikan Tuhan untuk menjadi berkat seluruh tubuh.
Likewise, every member of church has given by God for the blessing for all the body.
Ada yang bisa main piano. Ini Ibu Tobing pintar main organ.
There is an organist, pianist.
Saya hanya bisa main piano hanya dari kunci C.
I can play piano only.
Semua lagu saya bikin pakai kunci.
I can play piano but only note C.
Iya. Tapi ada orang yang bisa sampai berapa mol, berapa croix juga bisa dimainkan.
Some people can do everything.
Tapi saya juga puji Tuhan untuk itu.
But praise the Lord for me.
Dengan kunci C, saya bisa ciptakan 11 lagu rohani.
I can create it 11 songs.
Kemudian saya bujuk-bujuk istri saya.
And then I persuade my wife.
Bikin dulu yang ini jadi kunci F.
Please make it a note F.
Kemudian bikin dulu yang ini jadi dua croix.
And then please make it two croix.
Wah, jadilah 11 lagu itu berbeda-beda kuncinya.
And then finally 11 songs different notes.
Saudara, saya ceritakan ini untuk menekankan kepada kita betapa pentingnya kesatuan itu.
I tell this because I need to express that the importance of the unity.
You cannot walk alone.
Engkau tidak boleh berjalan sendirian.
Kita perlu bekerja sama dan harus punya kesatuan satu sama lain.
We need to work together so that we have unity.
Yesus menyatakan kebenaran universal dengan jelas.
Jesus gave the universal truth.
Di dalam Yohanes 13 ayat 34 dan 35.
In John 13 verse 34-35
disebutkan, dengan demikian semua orang tahu bahwa kamu adalah murid-muridku, yaitu jikalau kamu saling mengasihi.
And that many people will know that you are my disciple if you love one another.
Love one another.
Love, mencintai satu dengan yang lain.
Satu kesatuan.
Unity.
Tidak perlu banyak ngomong, kalau kita dilihat saling kerjasama, Tuhan pun akan dimuliakan.
No need to much talk, but if we are work together, God will be glorified.
Bagaimana supaya kita mencapai persatuan?
How can we reach the unity?
Mari kita baca Yohanes 17 ayat 20 sampai 23.
Let us open our Bible. Please open your Bible. John 17 verse 20 verse 23.
Dan bukan untuk mereka ini saja aku berdoa, tetapi juga untuk orang-orang yang percaya kepadaku oleh pemberitaan mereka. Supaya mereka semua menjadi satu, sama seperti engkau ya Bapa di dalam aku dan aku di dalam engkau, agar mereka juga di dalam kita. Supaya dunia percaya bahwa memberikan kepada mereka kemuliaan. Dan seterusnya. Saudaraku, inilah yang menjadi kunci kesatuan.
My brothers, this is the key of their unity.
Anda lihat ini? Apa ini? Saya ingat ini, saya dulu sering main dengan ini. Ini can adalah lingkar sepeda.
This is the wheel.
Anda lihat lingkar sepeda itu. Semakin mereka mengarah kepada satu, yaitu pusatnya,
where they are point to the center,
maka semakin dekatlah mereka satu sama lain.
They are closer one another.
Beginilah kita gambarkan hubungan kita satu sama lain.
This is the picture our relationship with other.
Kristus adalah pusat.
Christ is our the center.
Semakin Anda jauh kepada Kristus,
if you are farther from Christ,
maka semakin jauhlah persaudaraan kita.
We are more farther.
Amin. Jadi kunci kesatuan dan persatuan itu adalah,
so the key of the unity and oneness is,
mari masing-masing kita berusaha untuk dekat kepada Kristus.
Let us closer to Christ.
Kalau kita dekat kepada Kristus, pasti kita akan dekat satu sama lain.
Then we are close with another.
Bila mana kita dekat kepada Kristus sekali lagi, maka inilah yang terjadi.
If you are close to Christ, then this is will happen to us.
Kita melihat dengan mata rohani yang baru.
We will see with the new spiritual eyes.
Kalau saya melihat Pak J.H. Sitoru, saya lihat ada di sini, Bapak guru saya dulu.
If I see Mr. G.H. Sitoru, my teacher before.
Kalau saya melihat hamba Tuhan ini dengan mata rohani,
if I see the servant of God with this my spiritual eyes,
maka yang nampak kepada saya adalah segala kebaikannya.
And that appears to me is all his goodness.
Tapi kalau saya lihat dengan mata manusiawi saya, yang kelihatan cenderung adalah yang tidak baiknya.
But if I see someone with the worldly eyes, I will see the bad things in him.
Itulah sebabnya maka untuk dapat melihat orang yang baiknya saja perlu kehadiran Roh Kudus di hati kita.
That's why in order to see the good things in others, so we need the feeling of the Holy Spirit.
Sebab hanya Roh Kristus saja yang memampukan kita untuk melihat satu sama lain bahwa memang kita berbeda.
That, yes, of course, with the Holy Spirit we can see we are different one another.
Tapi walaupun kita berbeda,
but we even though we are different,
kita harus menjadi satu karena telah dipersatukan oleh Kristus. Amin.
We must become one because Christ has united us.
Hal-hal kecil yang dulunya pernah mengganggu kita,
the little things that in the last days, the last time that used to bother us,
akan dibingkai kembali oleh kasih karunia Kristus.
Jesus Christ with his grace will reframe it.
Permusuhan yang dimanjakan akan dilepaskan dalam terang kasih karunia-Nya yang megah.
Indulge enmity will be unleashed of the in the glorious of His grace.
Dendam lama dan perselisihan sebisa mungkin harus disisihkan.
All grudges and disputes should be put aside as much as possible.
Saya harus katakan bahwa masing-masing kita punya kelemahan.
I need to tell you that we have weakness.
Nobody is perfect.
Tidak ada orang yang sempurna.
Even the both of us as a ordained pastor,
walaupun kami sebagai seorang pendeta yang diurapi,
kami juga punya kelemahan.
We also have a weakness.
Tapi jangan pernah lihat kelemahan orang lain.
But never see the weakness of others.
Dendam lama dan perselisihan sebisa mungkin harus disisihkan.
All the grudges and disputes will be banished from our lives.
Penghalang-penghalang yang menghalangi kita untuk bersatu harus diruntuhkan.
All the barriers should be thrown away.
Saudara, kalau kita menerima Injil, maka Injil itu pun akhirnya akan menyembuhkan hubungan kita yang hancur.
Then if we receive the gospel, that it will heal our broken relationship.
Jika hanya sekedar mengharapkan atau merindukan persatuan, itu tidak akan cukup.
Wishing for longing, the unity is not enough.
Gereja yang hidup, dinamis, bersatu, dan yang bangkit, dan yang bertumbuh, dan maju adalah gereja yang anggota-anggotanya berdoa bersama-sama.
A church that is alive, dynamic, united, that's rising, and that's growing, advancing, is a church members who are praying together for the unity.
Saya sangat berterima kasih sekali untuk alumni UNAI.
I'm so thankful with the alumni UNAI.
Beberapa hari ini,
in these days,
sampai tanggal 10 nanti kalau saya tidak salah,
until December 10, if I'm not mistaken,
setiap jam 5 pagi,
every 5 a.m.,
alumni UNAI bersatu, berdoa bersama-sama.
Alumni Unity UNAI to pray.
Untuk mensupport KKR yang sedang berlangsung.
To support the revival.
Saya bersyukur oleh sebab mayoritas tenaga staf dan dosen juga gabung di sana.
I'm so thankful because almost all the staffs and lecturers here join.
Saudara, selain berdoa bersama-sama,
besides pray together,
mempelajari firman Tuhan bersama-sama,
we need to study the word of God together,
menjangkau komunitas kita bersama-sama,
I need to reach our community together,
maka Tuhan pun akan dimuliakan,
and then God will be glorified.
Saudaraku, misi Kristus tidak akan pernah bisa terselesaikan jika gereja dipenuhi dengan konflik.
My brothers, Christ's mission can never be completed if the church filled with the chaos, conflict.
Kristus mengajak masing-masing kita untuk bersatu dalam kasih persatuan sehingga kita bisa menjangkau dunia.
Christ invite each one of us to unite in love to reach the world.
Saya ingin baca satu kutipan dari tulisan Ellen White dalam buku Alpha dan Omega jilid 7 halaman 17 dan 18.
I want to read some quotations, a quotation from Ellen G. White, Alpha and Omega jilid 7.
Nyonya White tuliskan, persatuan ini adalah tujuan Kristus untuk mencapainya.
The union is the Christ's goal to achieve.
Kepada tujuan ini ia harus berusaha untuk membawa mereka ke dalam persekutuan dengan dirinya sendiri.
To this he must seek to bring them into communion with himself.
Nyonya White jelas sekali katakan.
Ellen G. White clearly says,
we cannot united.
Kita tidak akan bisa bersatu.
If we don't come to Christ,
jika kita tidak datang kepada Yesus Kristus,
because only Christ,
oleh karena Yesus Kristus sajalah,
can make us united,
yang membuat kita bersatu.
Saudara, Yesus menempatkan prioritas pada kesatuan gerejanya.
My brother, Jesus placed the priority of the unity of his church.
Seluruh perjanjian baru menempatkan kepentingan utama pada hubungan antara anggota gereja.
The entire New Testament places the primary importance of the relationship between church and members.
Jemaat yang berdoa dengan pesan dan misi yang sama akan menerima kuasa Roh.
the church who are praying together and has a mission same will receive the power of the Holy Spirit.
Dan Roh Kudus akan membuat dampak yang besar pada komunitas kita sebagai umat Kristus.
The Holy Spirit will make a great impact to our community for Christ.
Seperti murid-murid Kristus yang mula-mula.
Like the early disciples of Jesus Christ.
Yang bersatu dalam kasihnya.
Who were united in the love.
Saudara kita juga dapat membuat perbedaan di dunia kita saat ini.
We can also too have a difference.
Saya akan segera mengakhiri khotbah ini.
But I would like to finish this sermon.
Saya tidak berharap agar Anda menghafal semua isi khotbah ini.
I don't hope that you remember all the contents of the sermon.
Saya juga tidak berharap agar Anda menghafal judul khotbah ini.
I do not say that you should memorize the title of the sermon.
Anda bisa lupakan semua apa yang saya katakan.
You may forget all that what I say.
Tapi jangan lupakan satu atau tiga kata.
But do not forget these three words.
The importance of the unity.
Pentingnya persatuan.
Kalau Anda capek menghafal tiga kata itu, hafal saja satu kata.
If you are tired to memorize all these two words,
unity.
Hafallah persatuan.
Tuhan memberkati.
God bless you.
As the closing song, we sing from SD Hymnal number 469, Leaning on the Everlasting Arm. Please stand up.
Fellowship, what a joy divine, leaning on the everlasting arms. What a blessedness, what a peace is mine, leaning on the everlasting arms. Leaning, leaning, safe and secure from all alarms. Leaning, leaning, leaning on the everlasting arms. Oh, how sweet to walk in this pilgrim way, leaning on the everlasting arms. Oh, how bright the path grows from day to day, leaning on the everlasting arms. Leaning, leaning, safe and secure from all alarms. Leaning, leaning, leaning on the everlasting arms. What have I to dread? What have I to fear? Leaning on the everlasting arms, I have blessed peace with my Lord so near. Leaning on the everlasting arms, leaning, leaning, safe and secure from all alarms. Leaning, leaning, leaning on the everlasting arms.
Tuhan Allah Bapa di sorga, pada akhir acara kebaktian ini kami bersyukur kepada-Mu. Oleh karena Engkau begitu baik kepada kami, Engkau mengingatkan kami untuk perlunya masing-masing kami menjaga, memelihara kesatuan dan persatuan demi untuk kemajuan pekerjaan Tuhan di dunia ini. Bapa, ajar kami untuk dapat melakukannya.
Terima kasih Tuhan, oleh karena Engkau begitu baik kepada kami. Apabila kami meninggalkan rumah Tuhan ini, biarlah Allah Bapa, anaknya Yesus Kristus, dan persekutuan Roh Kudus akan memberkati kita semuanya, mulai dari sekarang sampai selama-lamanya. Di dalam nama Yesus kami berdoa. Amin.
We have this hope that burns within our hearts, hope in the coming of the Lord. We have this faith that Christ alone imparts, faith in the promise of His word. We believe the time is here when the nations far and near shall awake and shout and sing, hallelujah, Christ is King. We have this hope that burns within our hearts, hope in the coming of the Lord.